In this episode of the AI Show, join us to hear from Netta Habe, Principal Program Manager on the Microsoft Azure Cognitive Services team. Netta will show us how to extract data from document and forms using OCR and Form Recognizer. Make sure you take a look.
Welcome to the Form Recognizer session. In this session, we will extract data from documents and forms with OCR and Form Recognizer. Let's start with OCR. The Read API is an off-the-shelf model trained with millions of documents. It's available as a managed service and as a container, and it extracts text from documents, printed in handwriting, and also extract text in the wild from images. Our new computer vision API, Read 3.0, is now generally available. We also added support for the following new languages: Spanish, German, French, Italian, Portuguese, and Dutch. Forms are everywhere: invoice, application forms, tax forms, bank forms, medical forms, construction forms. Every company has forms. Even in these challenging times, various scenarios require data extraction from forms: unemployment forms, employees' sick leave forms, loan application, mortgage applications, COVID-19 relief applications, clinical forms, and more. Extracting data from these forms today is mostly manual, which requires long processing cycles. Form Recognizer enables you to extract text, key value pairs, and tables from your forms. The input to Form Recognizer is documents, PDF or images, and the output is structured text, key value pairs, and tables. It enables you to automate the process of extracting data from your forms. Form Recognizer is comprised of three parts: layout, extract text and tables, custom, tailored to your form and extract text, tables, and key value pairs, and pre-built, which are pre-built models pre-trained by us. Let's start with layout. Layout extract text and tables from your documents. It's an off-the-shelf model available as a managed service. To extract text and tables, all you need to do is send your document to the Layout API, and it will extract the text and tables and output a structured JSON output. As an example, let's try and extract data from the Unemployment Insurance Weekly Claims News Report. This is a weekly news report released every week by the Department of Labor. It's a multi-page PDF with lots of data that is released as a PDF document. To extract this data, text and tables, and enable analyzing the data, we will use Form Recognizer Layout API. Let's see a demo on how to extract this data. In this demo, we'll see how Layout extracts all the data from this document. This document is the news release of the Unemployment Insurance Weekly Claims, which has 10 pages. Some of them have text, some of them have tables, and what we want to extract is the big table with all this information so we can analyze it later. All we need to do is go to our layout. I created here a notebook that calls the Layout API. You enter your Form Recognizer endpoint. This endpoint is from the resource you created in the Azure portal, and it's key. And we call here the Layout API. So you can see we're calling Layout Analyze. Let's run this. Our new Analyze Layout API is an async API, so you will also need to get the get results. So let's call the get results. This calls the get results with the operation location ID returned from the Analyze Layout. This will run for a second on these 10 pages. And when it's finished running, let's print the output. So we can see that it extracted, and let's put them side by side. We can see that it extracted all the text in the document. So the connect, it starts from the right top corner, connect with DOL, transmission of materials, unemployment insurance, weekly claims. So all the text is extracted, but let's look for the visualization of our tables. So we'll scroll down over all the text. And now we can see that we also found several tables. So we can see a table in page 4 was extracted. Let's go to page 4. A table for page 4, weekend, April 4, 28th, was extracted. several pages before. And the table we were interested in is the table that starts on page 5. And we can see that it was also extracted with the first header as none, the next header as initial claims during weekend, April 18, then again none, then insurance unemployment, none and none. And then the first row, which has all the details, state, advance, prior week change, advance, prior week change. We can also see that and all the data, all the corresponding data in the relevant rows and columns. So Form Recognizer will extract the data with row 0, column 0, row 1, column 1, and will also tell you if it spans multiple rows or multiple columns. The output we'll get from Form Recognizer is a JSON output. Let's view this as a JSON file. Okay, and let's scroll up. So we have several parts to the results. One is the page result, which includes all the tables. So let's go to the table we wanted. That's the table on page 5. So this is page 4, page 5. Cells, so we can see column 1, this spans on multiple rows. So this one, the first column here spans on three columns. The first row here spans on three columns. And then we can see it was returned as column 1 spans 3. It's bounding box, the text within it, and the row is 0. The next column is column 4. It also spans 3 columns. It's row 0, and it's the next title, unemployment for week enabled. It's bounding box, and also it refers to the elements in the read results where all the text was extracted if you want to get the confidence of the words that were extracted. So you have all the data, column 1, row 1, bounding box, the text. So you have all the data to push into a SQL database or an Excel or any other place you want to do analyze and do a calculation on this data. So in a few seconds, we were able to extract all the data and all these tables from this 10-page document. We saw how we can extract text and tables with a layout form recognizer functionality. Let's now look how we can train a model to your forms with the custom functionality. Form Recognizer includes a custom option where you can train models specific to your forms and to your data. There are two available options. One is train without labels, which includes two steps, the train step and then the analyze step. When train without labels, no human labeling is required. It's especially useful when you have a variety of form types and you want to quickly train a model for all those form types. Only a handful of documents is needed to train without labels and to get started with Form Recognizer. You do the train, and then you can analyze documents. But today we'll focus on train with labels. In train with labels, you first provide human inputs to extract the values you care about and you label the forms. Then you train, and then you analyze. Again, only a handful of sample documents is required and needed to train a model. And you can get started with just fine forms. You have the ability to create a continuous feedback loop by adding additional forms to improve the accuracy of the model over time. To process mortgage application and loans, lenders need to extract data from lots of different types of forms. With Form Recognizer Custom Service, companies can train models to automatically extract the data they need from forms. Let's see how to train and analyze a document with Form Recognizer Custom Service by training a model and then analyzing a document. To demo this, we will use a request for transcript tax return form, which is usually required for loan and mortgage applications. To label the forms, we're going to use the Form Recognizer sampling labeling tool. The sample labeling tool is available as an open source. It's also available as a tryout site in our FOTT Azure website.net location, or as a Docker container that you can pull and deploy locally or an Azure cloud instance. I already created a project here. I started and created a project here for the forms we were looking at before. I already labeled the name, the SSN, the signature, the spouse, the not SSN, and the address. Let's also label the form type and signature here. So we're going to create a new tag and call it form type. And we're going to create another tag and call it spouse. signature. And we're going to label. So we select the form type, and we click on the form type to label it, and we select the spouse signature, and we click on it. Notice that the forms are already OCR'd, so everything that's highlighted are things that you can label. And we're going to label 5 forms to train a model. So bear me a few seconds. We're going to label the 5 forms. 3 more. And note that we can label printed, handwritten. Forms can be tilted, rotated. And this is our last one. And now that we labeled 5 forms, let's train a model. So we go to the train and we click on the train. This train button calls the form recognizer API with your endpoint and the blob storage location where the training files are and the label and OCR file. You can see that with the 5 forms that we just trained, we already got a model accuracy of 95%, and we can also see the estimated accuracy for each one of the labels that we trained. Let's analyze a file we didn't train on. Let's select the file to analyze, and let's run prediction on it. What the run prediction does is it sends this file to our form recognizer analyze form API with the model ID in the file, and it identifies what are the values and what are the labels that we want to extract. So we can see that it extracts John Doe as the name, SSN1, the signature that we labeled, the SSN2 that we labeled, the address, the form type, and the spouse signature. And we can see that it gave confidence to each one of the labels and the values that were extracted. The output from Form Recognizer is a JSON output file. 3 parts. The read result, which is all the text that was extracted from the document, its bounding box, and confidence. The page results, which are the tables that was extracted from the documents if they were tables, and the document results, which are all the key value pairs that we just labeled. We can see that the doc type is custom form because we trained with a custom form, and we can see that the first field, for example, is that we labeled is spouse signature. It's string. It's a string. The valued string is Mary Doe extracted, and the text, it's on the first page, it's bounding box, and it's confidence, and there's also a reference to the extracted text in the read results section if you want to look at the confidence for the words that were extracted. So this confidence is the key value pair match. And in the read results, you also have the confidence that the OCR extracted this word correctly. We can see also the other value we labeled is SSN2. It's also a type string, the value of the string, the text, the bounding box, and the confidence. And note that when we label, you can assign different types to different values. So you can assign a type string, a type date, a type currency, a type number. This will enable the value string to be standardized and also improve the OCR, the extraction quality. In the custom train with labels demo, we saw you can easily train a model to extract the values of interest. Let's see how customer and partners are using Form Recognizer. Automation Anywhere, a leading robotic process automation provider, has partnered with government, health organization, and other first responders to streamline their operations and accelerate emergency response. The National Health Service in the UK currently processes tens of thousands of COVID-19 tests daily, and that number is expected to increase to over 1,000 tests per day. Before each sample can be processed, an E28 form must be logged into the system. The high volume of forms paired with a manual entry has the potential to cause significant delays in testing and diagnosis. Additionally, once a patient has been confirmed positive for COVID-19, several case report forms must be filed with the World Health Organization. Microsoft and Automation Anywhere work together to automate the World Health Organization form for reporting COVID-19, rapidly making essential data available in a digital form for the National Health Service in the United Kingdom, to help accelerate the reporting and processing of many complex forms, including the CRFs and E28s. This highly secure solution is comprised of Automation Anywhere RPA with native intelligent document processing and Microsoft OCR and Form Recognizer. The solution automatically extracts and processes data from forms, including handwriting and checkboxes. It can be rapidly deployed on cloud or on-prem and can scale to handle tens of thousands of pages a day. The solution enables to easily digitize the information to improve decision-making and offload frontline staff to spend more time on higher priority tasks. We saw a form recognizer can extract text and tables using layout, train a custom model tailored to your forms. Form recognizer also includes pre-built models, where the first pre-built we released is a receipt pre-built for US sales receipt, like store receipt and restaurant receipts. The pre-built receipt models is an off-the-shelf model which has only one step, analyze receipts. You can send your receipt using the Analyze Receipt API, and it will extract key fields in those receipts like merchant, subtotal, total, tax, line item from English sales receipts in the US. The pre-built receipt extracts data from US sales receipt like restaurant receipt and store receipts. It will extract the following fields: merchant name, merchant address, phone number, date, time, subtotal, tax, total, and tip. It will also provide per receipt the receipt type, if it's an itemized, credit card, restaurant receipt, the field confidence level, and also the line item, the quantity, the product, and the amount. All this data will be automatically extracted once you send a receipt to the Form Recognizer Analyze Receipt model. In this session, we saw a form recognizer can extract text, tables, and key value pairs, and how customers integrated are now using form recognizer. Following are additional resources on form recognizer. Thank you.